Hey guys, Dr. Norm again. Wanted to talk about care plans. And when I say care plans, it's recommending to the patient the amount of visits and the frequency that you're recommending to get them back to health. Okay? I had a patient who came in just recently, and they were all excited because they were approved for X amount of visits, and they were like, great, I can come in all this time. Well, after I did the exam on them, I determined they're not going to need that many visits, and they couldn't understand why I wouldn't let them come in more often. The way I explained it, I said, you can come in as many times as you want, but if I check you and I don't find anything wrong, we're not going to adjust you and we're not going to bill you. So you need to figure out, and this will come through experience, but you'll need to figure out what does a particular patient need as far as visits, as far as treatment, as far as recommendations, whether it be nutrition or exercise or something like that. And then you need to recommend only that. Once you start recommending beyond what you think they need, now you're doing it for money, or you're doing it for your stats, or you're doing it for something different. Okay. So, and also, if you recommend less than they need, if you think, oh, I don't want to scare this guy off, so let me recommend fewer visits, then that's not what you should be doing either. Either way, if you're recommending too little or too much, you're lying to the patient. You need to be able to look them in the eye, say, here's exactly what you need. I don't care if your insurance will pay for more. I don't care if your insurance will pay for less. That's not why I'm here. I'm here to fix your subluxations. Here's what it's going to take, period. Okay? So start that right out of the gate. Start being able to talk with integrity and really just stand up for what you determine they need. Obviously, that can change as the patient comes in. You might have to increase the care plan or decrease the care plan depending how they're doing. But once you start recommending either something a management coach tells you to do, or something based on what the insurance company tells you they'll pay for, or you're doing something for acceptance, then you're not being a real chiropractor anymore. Now you're just you're letting something else other than the patient determine the care plan, and you shouldn't be doing that. Okay? I'm really proud to be talking to you guys, because just the fact that you're watching this video, I know that you're a type of you're a student who wants to be a quality chiropractor who has good integrity. So keep fighting the good fight.